October 28th's iteration of Raw wasn't that special, as it turned out to be yeet this, yeet that, a yeet smack, with a curb stomp on Bronson's neck.
Mega stomp! He just made him a hood ornament!
Today on Joshua's Breakdown, I'll be discussing Jay, Jimmy, and Sammy, and Bronson Reed and Seth's match at Crown Jewel. If you're interested in seeing more content, be sure to follow the Two Small Marks Instagram and Threads account, where we cover all wrestling shows live. Jay and Jimmy started Monday Night Raw this week, coming off of them helping the Motor City Machine Guns win the tag titles from the Bloodline. The meeting wasn't all smiles though, as Sammy spots Jay in the back and ends up showing some animosity towards Jimmy. Sammy then asks Jay why he would get back involved after what Roman did to him, and because he made such a name for himself on his own. Jay simply responds he wouldn't understand because he's not family.
Just don't understand.
No, Sammy, you wouldn't understand. Because you're not family, Lucy.
Which seemed to leave a bad taste in Sammy's mouth. Jimmy then convinced Jay that he would talk to Sammy, but before he gets a chance to, Sammy is seen talking to Solo, which causes Jay and Jimmy to feel like they can't trust Sammy. And Sami Zayn now being involved in the storyline shows they're already building towards a Bloodline versus Bloodline match at War Games. I believe Sami will end up on Jay's side with Roman, but it'll be interesting to see if Sami will forgive Roman and what exactly that would look like, or if Roman will apologize to Sami, which will contribute to him joining. And I think Roman apologizing and making amends with everyone he's done wrong while being Tribal Chief will be great for his continued character development and make his arc that much better. Earlier on in the night, Seth Rollins came out to tell Hershey, Pennsylvania that he's hunting monsters. But before he could tell him the type of net he'll use, Big Bronson Reed interrupts him. Reed then tells him he's waiting in the back. Seth Rollins ain't no b**** though, so he definitely went backstage to confront him. And as expected, it ended in a brawl. This happening less than a week from the match at Crown Jewel heightens the excitement for the match even more. Seth has hinted that he's turning back into the old Seth Rollins, which could end in a heel turn in the near future. But when it comes to the match at Crown Jewel, it's possible that Seth Rollins will win, but if he doesn't, it will be partly because of this brawl and Seth hurting himself, which will hinder him during the match. I also think Bronson Reed picking up this win on Seth Rollins will be great for his push, even if Seth manages to win in a rematch. Bronson has been able to effectively handle everything that has been thrown at him, and it wouldn't be a surprise if you see him in the IC title picture at some time in the near future. The only thing that would guarantee that this match would be good though, if it was a last man standing. Nevertheless, if the match at Crown Jewel is anything like these encounters, it should end up being good. Be sure to check out new audio episodes of the Two Small Marks Wrestling Show every Saturday, and be sure to like and subscribe for more videos.